Alright, so the footage I shot earlier might have been unusable. Anyway, right now I'm on my way down to Rehoboth Beach, Delaware, Dewey Beach, Delaware. And we are going to go to the Dogfish Head Craft Brewery. So I am extremely excited. Oh, wow, I caught that light. I am super excited. Like I made a totally illegal U-turn. Anyway, I'm super excited. We're going to go to the Dogfish Head Brewery. Maybe try some new beers. Get a tour. It's basically like one of my favorite places in the world. Hang out with my buddy Peter. And probably go to the Dogfish Head Brew Pub as well. And I think other than that, check out some, check out the beach. We're at the beach, might as well go. We find ourselves at the Dogfish Head Brewery. When you check in, they give you 4 free samples of different beer that you can try. So I've been trying a couple of different beers that you can only get here. They're called Alternative Takes 2, 4. I tried another one called Beer for Breakfast, which is this one I've had. You can get this one at a bunch of different stores. I have never tried it yet because unfortunately I can't get it. I know Peter's shaking his head. Why don't you see Peter? I've never had this yet. This one's interesting. It's called Beer for Breakfast. It's a stout, correct?
Yes.
Yeah, so it's a stout, but they make it with scrapple, a couple other kind of breakfast foods, coffee. So it actually almost tastes like you're literally having breakfast, and it's actually delicious. I don't even like stouts, but this is amazing.
So come on over here, and we're gonna do a little history lesson on camera. Craft beer bar now, this is 1993. Probably weren't a lot of craft beer bars anywhere, even in New York City. So if you've ever worked in the bar or restaurant business, such as yourself, at the end of your shift, you get something called a shift drink. And one night they asked Sam what he wanted for his shift drink, and he said, looking at the list, he said, I think I'll have a Sierra Nevada Celebration Ale. Who here's had a Sierra Nevada Celebration Ale? So we know it's a seasonal beer, but it's not really a seasonal beer because it doesn't have nutmeg, it doesn't have cinnamon. Allen's system up and running. He's got his brew pub up and running. And on Memorial Day weekend, 1995, Dogfish Head Brewing and Eats becomes the first brew pub in the first state of Delaware. Now, Sam's idea of brewing was not your typical idea of brewing, evidenced by those cherries that he had thrown. He takes that game to the brew pub. He puts it on a tripod, similar to this one. He buys himself a 5-gallon bucket, similar to this one. He drills holes in it, similar to these holes. I like to see how many times I can say similar in this presentation. And then what he does is he takes that bucket, he duct tapes it to this game, and then he turns the game on, and this is what the game does. This is all the game does. It vibrates. I had one of these when I was a kid. Basically, the players go around in circles. They fall over, they don't actually go anywhere. But what this did for Sam is that bucket vibrated and those hop pellets dropped out of the holes in his bucket. And what he could do is he could either raise his bucket or lower, raise his game or lower it to affect the angle to either speed up the process or slow it down. So those hop pellets going down here, they score a touchdown, they drop it. Instead of one against Sam, even though he was an English major, especially when you take into consideration all that he's accomplished. But, so as all of his friends love 90 Minutes, a great beer if you're sitting at home, you can have a couple of them. But if you're down at the brew pub and you want to have more than one, it's like, well, you really would like to be able to drive home, but you're...
Alright, so for anyone who's a beer aficionado, if you've ever known Dogfish, the thing that they're known for, besides all their crazy creative beers that are amazing, is continuously hopping IPAs. This was the birth of continuously hopping IPAs. They literally took this thing, shook pellets of pelletized hops, and threw it in the bucket. Well, not a bucket, that is where they're actually brewing the beer. and that was the birth of continuously hopped IPAs. But then after that, they grew up, and Sir Hopsalot did that. He got Sam Gallione, he's the owner of Dogfish, the founder, got together as engineer buddies and made this thing. So that was basically the birth of actual professional continuously hopped IPAs. So, if anyone likes 120 minute IPA, that's where it's made.
Here for breakfast, 120 minute IPA. It has its own continuous hopping system, which is that thing with the stainless steel back behind there. And it does have its own name as well too. And the name was taken from three pictographs. So the first pictograph is a sofa. So think of a sofa. The second pictograph is a king's crown. So think of a crown. Think of a king. The third one is hops, hopping, and we call it sofa king hopping. So say that over kind of slowly in your head, and that's what we named that system. And there's the joke. How did I do with it? All right, so we're gonna head down to we're all about safety here. Now when we last left our ward upstairs, 210 degrees. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna move that ward down to 65 degrees to get out our heat. And that's the difference. Perfect quiet here. We have two rooms here. The room on my right, again, we need to keep the middle here clear, so if we can step over. Yeah, we'll go over here. So this is our yeast room. So this is where the yeast is being added. So I like to call it a very sciencey room, because we have people a lot smarter than I that know what goes on in here. Normally we have about four or five different strains of yeast that we work with, but we do have a proprietary strain of yeast, and we call that our doggy yeast, and we use it. And then we have two other barrels back here in this corner, which look different than the oak barrels, and that's our Palisanto barrel. We have two of those. One is 10,000 gallons, the other one is 6,000 gallons, and we only age one beer in those barrels, and that's our Palisanto Moreno. It's story time, kids. We're John Gasparini, and John is a commercial hardwood floor salesman. John's wife is from Paraguay. So one summer, John and his wife go down to Paraguay to visit her family. They go to a wine tasting, and John gets a chance to try a very nice red wine that has been aged on Palo Santo chips. Now John thinks, well, if you could do this with wine, why couldn't you do this with beer? Being such a big fan of Dogfish Head and knowing how Sam likes to brew beer, basically using any ingredient that he can find, testing it out to see if it works, John thought, well, maybe Sam could do something with some Palo Santo chips. So John brings back about 5 kilos of chips, gets them down to Sam at the brewery, and Sam decides to brew an Imperial Brown Ale and put it in those wood chips. That was to this day, as far as I know, it was the fastest selling small batch beer ever brewed at the brew pub. It sold out in one day. Sam obviously gets excited, right? He's got this great beer, but he's only got 5 kilos of chips, so he wants to brew more beer. He calls up John, says, John, I need more Palo Santo wood. I'm gonna build a 10,000 gallon barrel. And John's like, oh, sure, Sam, that shouldn't be any big deal. I'll go down to Paraguay. So John hops a plane. He flies down to Paraguay. He gets met at the airport by a white van. He hops in the van, and in the back of the van are about 7 or 8 native Paraguayans. And they're back there sharpening machetes, and they're sharpening axes. And John is thinking, wow, I just made a really bad life choice here. So they drive for about 7 hours out into the wilds of Paraguay. Now, Palo Santo tree does not grow in the rainforest. My wife asked me that question. I looked it up. It doesn't grow in the rainforest, but it does just grow out in the wild. It's not a very impressive looking tree. So they drive about 7 hours. They stop the van and they all jump out. And they walk up to a tree, and it's no bigger around than this yellow stanchion you see here or over back here. And it grows kind of gnarly and it doesn't get real tall. And the first Paraguayan walks up with a machete, and he takes a mighty swing at that tree, and the machete just bounces right off. The next guy gets out with an axe, and he takes a swing at that tree, and the axe just bounces off. Now the driver, being a resourceful guy, he goes back to the van, and he pulls a .38 revolver out from under the seat. Now John's really worried about this life choice he's just made. That driver walks up to that tree, he shoots that tree 6 times, those bullets just bounce off the tree. John was not aware of the fact that Palo Santo was one of the hardest, densest, commercially traded woods in the world. You can't cut it with a machete. You can't chop it with an axe. You can't even shoot it with a gun. Rumor has it, it took about 17 industrial diamond tip saw blades to cut enough wood for Sam to make his barrel. So the wood gets cut, it gets sent back up to the United States, and then it sits in customs because not only is it hard and dense and you can't shoot it, it doesn't float in water, it sinks and you can't x-ray it. So here's all this wood, it's heavier than it's supposed to be. It's just come from South America, right? So customs has no idea what they're dealing with and why this wood is so heavy.
It's also very correct first.
Alright, so something pretty neat. That treehouse up there was actually bought at Burning Man. They hold business meetings up there sometimes. I like this place.
And sanitized. Now once they're done there, they're filled upside down because it takes a lot less time to fill a keg upside down. And then once they're full, they're going to proceed over here and they're going to come to the end of this line down here. And that robot, who some people call Killer, other people call Big Bird, is going to pick up that full keg, rotate it around so it's right side up, move it over, have a label put on it, have a white cap put on it, and then bring it over here to the splitter, and today's date will be printed on there so we know that deal was packaged. So you can watch Killer do his thing, or her thing. And then once that pallet is full, the pallet goes down underneath the Blue Landtech machine, where it gets wrapped in plastic, goes to the end of the... The other reason we'll always bottle is it costs a whole lot of money. And they come in on these pallets, and we get them from a company called Owens, Illinois. And our bottles are anywhere from 45 to 70% recycled material. So when the pallets are unloaded, they're gonna come over here. Co-worker is going to unwrap them and unsnap the bands. They're gonna move up to here, and we've got a robotic arm that's gonna pick up that pallet cover and drop it into a stack over here. They have to, I think there were four bottles that had actually gotten kicked out because of whatever problem. That may not even have been a problem, but they were kicked out anyway. So once that's done, bottles are ready to be filled, and they're gonna go into that enclosure where you get hung upside down so they can dry. Once those bottles were dry, the next person would grab two bottles at a time and fill two bottles at a time. The third person would be over here, and in the early days they were actually corking a lot of the beer. They would either cap or cork one bottle at a time. It took three people 8 hours to do 100 cases of beer. We can now do 11,500 in a day. So when Sam started Dogfish Head Brewing in East back in 1995, there were approximately 800 breweries in the country. Breweries are based on volume. Remember, Sam was doing 2 10-gallon batches a day. A barrel of beer is 31 gallons, so he wasn't even doing one barrel a day.
So this behind me right here is 2 to 3 weeks worth of beer. It's one of the most beautiful things I've ever seen in my life. Just look at it.
It's amazing.
It's so beautiful.
Essay, Emerson's essay on, it's called Self-Reliance, and I will read it to you because I have not memorized it yet, but what it says is, whoso would be a man must be a nonconformist. He who would gather immortal palms must not be hindered by the name of goodness, but must explore if it be goodness. Nothing is at last sacred but the integrity of your own mind. And basically, this was too long to put on a bottle label, so Sam shortened it to off-centered ales to off-centered people. Basically, like what you like. Don't worry if other people like things that you don't like and vice versa. Search out goodness in your life. Search out other people who have similar interests in you. And when good people get together in the name of goodness, good things happen. That's kind of what it is.
Yeah. Cheers, brother.
Grass, yes.
You should rotate it. Like, do the whole, like...
Can you rotate it? Can you rotate your wood?
I love my wood. This is really hard.
That's really hard wood.
It's the hardest commercially traded wood in the world.
Bulletproof.
So that's the Palo Santo wood that Palo Santo Ale is actually made in. What's interesting is like this is the wood that you can shoot with a pistol, like a 32 special. Or excuse me, a 38 special. What am I talking about? And it doesn't penetrate. It's almost kind of bulletproof wood. It's crazy. But I just had some Palo Santo Ale, and it's amazing. So if you get the chance to try it, I highly recommend it.
Grandma, Grandburger, kill you. Come here, Fee. Hey, come here. Oh, sorry. So this is my first time back in the beach in over a year, I think, actually almost closer to two. We grew up going to the beach pretty much every summer. I was always either at the Jersey Shore, which is where my mom grew up, or came down here because this is where all my friends go, because obviously we live in Delaware. So finally, after living in a desert and being in a desert for, you know, well over a year, back by the sea. And life is good. Real good. So Peter, what did we just have?
All of the new Dogfish Head whiskeys. It's pretty good. We had single malt whiskeys, four grain whiskeys, and they were all aged differently. A couple of them were straight from the distillery, so they weren't aged at all. There's nothing extra to them. They weren't put in any barrels. Then the other ones were aged differently. A couple of them were aged for 5 months, a couple aged for 7 months. Pretty good stuff. If you're in the Rehoboth area over the summer, come out to Chesapeake in Maine, and all summer they're gonna have discounted whiskey flights for everybody to try. They're looking for as much R&D research as possible, so come on out.
I just had them, I'm a little drunk, and they're good. No, I'm not drunk, I drink responsibly. But anyway, they're good, you should try some. Exciting. Back in the day, we used to drive 40 minutes out of the way to get milkshakes at this one Wawa in southern New Jersey, and it was like one of only like two Wawas out of all the Wawas that existed that had milkshakes and smoothies, but not milkshakes. Well, anyway, now they have milkshakes here in Delaware. I'm super excited. I've been waiting for this day for a long time, and it's happened while I'm here. Alright, so for anyone that doesn't know, this is Wawa, and it's one of the, is it not one of the best things ever?
It's the best thing ever.
Yeah, it's the best things ever. It's like one of the seven, you know, wonders of the world, like, you know, the pyramids of Egypt, Great Barrier Reef, America, small block V8s, Belvedere vodka. I don't really know, but anyway, the point is, it's amazing, it's good. And they have everything here. They have coffee, the prices are great, huge selection of, you know, all those kinds of regular drinks and whatnot. And then also here they have these little screens that you can actually order fresh food from. So they'll make like sandwiches for you, all these different kinds of sides, and they even have like milkshakes and stuff now. So it's wonderful, it's awesome. And if you're not from like the Philadelphia area, the Mid-Atlantic, Delaware, New Jersey, Maryland, or whatever, you probably don't have a Wawa, and that sucks for you because it's so good.